Hey guys, hope you're doing great. In this video, I am going to show you how you can propagate dahlia from cuttings. By the way, I have many videos on dahlias and I will be adding the link on the description box. So please check out if you want more information on dahlia. So this is one of my dahlia plant, and from this I am going to collect the cuttings. And it's really important to remove the top part of the dahlia if you are growing from the seedling or even cuttings, and that way your plant would look more bushier, and at the same time you can produce more number of plants if you want to. But I already did this thing for one of my dahlia plant, and since I did not record the video at that time, I just thought to record the video and show you how you can do it, and it's really very easy. So this is one of my cuttings which I did almost 20 days back, and for this, after cuttings, I just kept the pot in a bright light but not in the direct sunlight. And now I am keeping the pot after 10 days, I am keeping the pot in a place where it get near about 2 hours of direct sunlight. And from today onward, I would be going to keep the pot on terrace. And please guys, make sure to watch the full video, because I am going to update the video until and unless I don't get flowers on these cuttings, which were propagated from by the cutting. Sorry for too many errors. So now let's start the process and you can just follow me. So first thing is, we need to get the cuttings ready, and for that I am taking a sterilized blade here. Please make sure to sterilize the blade with any kind of hand sanitizer. I just did with the hand sanitizer. Cut in horizontal way if possible. Alright, as you can see, I got a nice cutting of dahlia plant, and now I am going to remove most of its leaves. Okay, this is what it looks, and if you are growing dahlia, just go for at least 8 inches of a pot. But since I don't have 8 inches of pot ready at this time, I am just going to grow this cutting in a 6 inches of a pot. And I already prepared my potting mix. As you can see, for the potting mix I am taking the same way like for many of my plants do, like 50% of garden soil, 25% of vermicompost, and rest 25% of cocoa peat. You can also use sand instead of cocoa peat if you don't have cocoa peat ready at your home at this time. So now next thing I am going to do is, I am just cutting this part in a diagonal way, and I am going to bury until this part so that new roots can produce. Just the scratching on the surface, but it's really not needed if you don't want to do. Now I'm going to dip the stem on water and then going to rub the rooting hormone powder. If you don't have rooting hormone powder, you can also use cinnamon, but I am really not sure how effective cinnamon is, as I haven't found any good result using cinnamon. But yes, I have found good result using honey. So if you don't have rooting hormone powder, you can also use honey. But yes, even if you don't use, it's absolutely fine, because I did not use anything with my cuttings, whatever I have shown you. Now going to make a hole here, so that just use any tool, or if your finger, if the stem is not that big, and then going to keep the stem here. Just press the soil a bit. Okay, that's it. It's really very simple, as you have seen here. Now just after planting your cuttings, please keep the pot in a bright area for next few days, let's say 10 or 12 days, and as soon as you see some new growth on your cutting, then only keep the pot in a place where it would be getting the direct sunlight. Now please keep watching, and like I said, I am going to show you lots of blooms at the end of the video. Hey guys, updating the video almost after 90 days, and today's date is 19 February 2019. By the way, this is what I promised you at the beginning part, and I'm really very glad that finally I'm able to show you the blooms on my dahlia cuttings. And if you remember, the day when I recorded the first one of the video, that time my other dahlia cutting was nearly about 20 days old, and that's why I am counting it as a 90 days. And now you can see that my plant is blooming really very well. As you can see, lots of buds too. So in coming few days, it's going to look much more attractive. And honestly saying, I really can't expect better result than this from a 6.5 inches of a pot. So now you know that you can grow dahlia cuttings very easily. I mean, you can propagate dahlia by the cuttings very easily. And at the same time, you can also get the great result. Please note that in this video, I am not going to talk too much about how you can care for the dahlia plants and how to grow it, because I have a different video where I have shown everything. I mean, I have shown from the seedling stage to until flowering. So if you want to know more about dahlia, please check out that video. I will put the link in the description box. So I am going to end the video right here, because for this video, my aim was to show you bloom at the end, and this is the result. And I really hope that you are liking the end result. Now, if you have any questions or any other gardening questions, just write down the comment below and I will get back to you as soon as possible. And at the same time, if you have experience of growing dahlias, please share your experience with us so that many viewers along with myself would be able to learn something new from you. So guys, thank you very much for taking your time to watch the video, and if you found this video useful or informative, please don't forget to like it, share it and subscribe to my channel if you haven't. And even if you did not like it, please feel free to comment on it so that I can improve myself. Also, before leaving, please also do check out the video where I have showed how easily you can propagate kalanque by cutting. Thank you once again. Have a great day.